Hi, it's Megan. So I have a brand new habit, Burberry cosmetics. So as if Tom Ford wasn't bad enough, I decided to add some Burberry to the mix. And so now I have four of the Kisses lipsticks. And right now on my lips, I have Nude Cashmere. So these are $33 for 0.11 ounce. And on Sephora's site, there are 28 shades plus the Holiday Gold. And I've already done a review for the Holiday Gold, which was the first one I tried. And I found that what worked in that review works with all of them. They actually kind of remind me of Korean lip products in that they're pretty sheer. And a lot of times they're super, super pigmented. So they don't seem quite as sheer as they are, because they're actually not so sheer, if that makes sense. There's so much pigment in them, but they don't have a lot of the other heavier stuff in lipsticks, which gives it that look of opacity. But with a lot of the darker shades, and even this right here, Nude Cashmere, there's a certain element of that really amazing, beautiful balance of a really gorgeous shine, and then intense pigmentation, but with a lighter formula that doesn't look with that kind of white base thing that got really popular, or that super creamy satiny look. And I would venture to say they look a little bit more natural on. And the other thing, before I read the description and go into more detail, the other thing I would say about the colors that I got, so I got Nude Cashmere, I got Blush 77, I got Oxblood, and I got Garnet. And these can be hard to get. Oxblood in particular can be hard to get because it sells out a lot, but I didn't find a lot of reviews. So I had to I always go on my own opinion as well, but this is totally my own opinion. I didn't even double check anything because I really couldn't find much. I double checked just to make sure I'm not completely crazy. And sometimes even if I'm completely crazy, I put it in the video anyway, because, you know, my opinion is my opinion. But they are really, really amazing in how they have this beautiful shine and good wear time. The Nude Cashmere on me is about the shortest, probably an hour to an hour and a half. But as you see, there's really great coverage for a really light color, which once I swatch it, you'll see exactly how light it is. Really great coverage. And that sheen without shimmer, just, I don't know, it's really pretty. It's more natural looking a lot of times than some of the lipsticks. So you have to kind of like that look. And I would venture to say, some people will hate these lipsticks, but based on the Sephora reviews, where there are a fair number of reviews, they had like a 5-star. Most people love them. So, according to Burberry, this weightless lip color delivers a customizable look, leaving a single touch of color for understated sheen, or you can apply 3 layers to create intense depth and vibrancy. And by the way, that actually is true. If you just put on the one layer, and maybe we'll play with the last one, Oxblood, which is the darkest, and build it up, because that'll show most on camera. So, the rich infusion of satin-finished pigments with shiny polymers offers luminous brilliance infused with Burberry's signature blends of rosehip, tea, and lavender. I don't smell lavender, though. And they say it's fragrance-free. I don't smell lavender, but it's there. Its ultralight texture glides on with maximum comfort while providing continuous hydration. No paraben, sulfates, and free of fragrance and lanolin. And lanolin is, I think it was a sheep or goat oil-based product. And if you want vegan, you can't have lanolin. So, they have this amazing Burberry packaging. And then, which color do I have here? I don't want to start with that one. I want to start with Nude Cashmere. So this is number 25. You take it out of the package, and it's got the Burberry pattern, silver. And then it's got the magnetic enclosure, which I don't know if anyone cares, but that's more expensive packaging by far than most other lipsticks when you have that magnetic thing. So this is Nude Cashmere. It's a very odd color off, and it's actually an odd color to describe. I've gotten kind of used to describing different colors. This one is one of those that kind of threw me a little bit. So if you see the shade right here, like, what color is that? That's like a taupe peach with a touch of brown. That's what I came up with. And on the lips, I have pretty pigmented lips, and that's why I do the color change on camera, just because there are certain things that are going to look one way on me, but if you've got very differently pigmented lips, It's going to be very different. So at least you get to see the difference that my lip shade makes. This is the kind of shade that applied very sheer just kind of shines up, nudes out your natural lip color. Or adds a touch of like the brown taupe peach thing. And it kind of just depends on your lip color. This one I have a soft spot for lip colors like this. I don't know why, but I love them. I think it's so sophisticated. I love the shine. I just love it. But not everyone's gonna be able to wear this. This is an easier nude than most. And yes, you can build it up to build up this color. And I did build it up a little. This is probably two coats, so you could see it better. But I'm guessing that people that are super cool toned, like my daughter, not a good color for them. Just my personal hunch. If she were a little bit more obedient, I'd track her down and make her wear it. But we're not gonna make the kids suffer. The next one is Blush 77, and this is quite an interesting shade. So I wrote down rich warm pink, and it's a medium intensity pink. So again, you can put it on. We'll do one swipe. You can see, even if you put it on for one swipe, you're not getting no color at all. This is an intensely pigmented pink. It's not dark, and there you see, now all of a sudden it looks a little bit more like a traditional lipstick, but you can again see that softer look to it, to the texture. I need a better way of describing it. Because there are sheers. This is not a sheer, but it's more like a popsicle kind of color as opposed to an ice cream kind of color. Water-based looking. Even though it's not. I guess I can smell. Just a slight touch of lavender, very, very faint. Almost not there. If you're super sensitive to lavender or scents though, you will smell it. Barely there. Look how pretty that is. It just, I don't know, it brightens up your face. It's really natural looking. Really gorgeous, in my opinion. I obviously like these a lot. And this I think will work on most skin tones because it is a warmer pink. The next one is Garnet. And Garnet is kind of like a lighter Oxblood. I wrote it's a lighter pinker Oxblood. It's like a russet red pink, a rich russet red pink. So here it is. And in the tube, I think they look slightly different than they look on. And honestly, I thought the Sephora pictures were more in the tube, which would make sense since it's a picture in the tube, but not necessarily indicative of how they look on. And I get about 2 hours wear time plus with the darker shades. Like I said, about 1.5 with the first. It feels very balm-like. Very light, and it is on me hydrating, but I typically don't have a dry lip problem, although with the kind of crazy weather we've had this year, my lips have been getting drier. So we'll do one coat, then we'll add another. See, it's just, I don't know, I'm looking at it, it's just so pretty. That's the thing I was gonna say about these that I forgot earlier. Certain brands just grasp color, and they just work on. It's nice when you have a great color selection off people, but I think there are certain brands that are just better able to figure out what color works on a person. And so these don't always look quite as exciting in the tube, but as I put them on, I'm like, wow, that is such an amazing color. And that's a true gift. I think NARS is really good at that. YSL, Tom Ford. Just certain brands grasp it. And Burberry. So here we've got Oxblood. This is the one that sells out all the time. I was so curious. When it popped back in stock, I was so excited to get it. See how beautifully they just evenly apply. It really is just a nice, nice formula on. So I'm going to put this next to Garnet so you can see the difference. So I said I think this really is a red, but barely a red. And I see blue and purple in it. It's kind of a slightly cooler tone, except it does have a touch of brown. So it's going to work on most colors. So there's Oxblood and there's Garnet. Garnet is definitely pinker, less red. Building it up, it becomes just really a rich, rich pigmented. Now it looks a little bit more red than when I first put on just one coat. And there we'll do the third. And again, it doesn't have that heavy white look that a lot of lipsticks recently have started having, that kind of opacity that's kind of in your face. It's just a really rich color. So I have nothing bad to say about these, honestly. I just love them. I think they're amazing. Just really, really pretty. If you have other colors, I'm super curious. I got these during the Friends and Family sale at Sephora, so I was kind of excited about that. I got a discount on them because they are expensive, but if you have other colors that you just love or adore or think are amazing, or colors that you don't like or anything else, I would love to hear. Please subscribe on YouTube. I'm sorry things have been going up a little slower. I've had Wi-Fi issues now. If it's not one thing, it's another, or internet or whatever. Thanks very much and happy holidays.